So let's take a walk through the Special Edition Volume 1 and Plus, and we'll start with the Synchronized Special Edition Solo Strings. You see up to 30 different instruments and sections are waiting here for you with the Synchron Concert D274 Lite with its own player. Just check the video for that. We'll start with the solo strings, and I'll just play through the available articulations, just doodling along just to give you an impression of what's in there. You'll see me key switching there, short notes, staccato. We'll start with that, then go to the detaché, the long notes, sustains, marcato, and the crossfade tremolo. You can always see what I'm doing when I'm using the controllers here. Let's go. Going to the long notes. Starting with the sustains. The marcato. And I can use CC1 to control how much of the attack I want to have marcato. This is no marcato. The crossfade tremolo, from sustain to tremolo. This is CC20. I'll just reassign that. I'll do that anytime. And just reassign it to CC4. The legato without portamento. Dynamics. Slot crossfade tremolo. Again, CC4. Tremolo. And the pizzicato. So that's the solo violin one as it is in the volume one. Plus adds a lot more articulations to the short notes. I'm just uploading the plus preset. You get short detachés. Just give you a quick example here. You get staccatos. Short detachés. Normal detachés. Legato repetitions. And spiccato repetitions. Repetitions are always a round robin of up to 9 recorded repetitions, so you get the actual note transitions. The spiccato is just so alive. It's a really great addition there. With the plus articulations, you also get the forte piano. Sounds like this. And the forte piano in a crossfade to tremolo. If I want to crossfade this, I'm taking this, learning this again to my CC4. So you can, you have a lot, you have more dynamics there. You have trills, half-tone trills. And whole-tone trills. You have fast repetitions, like a controlled tremolo. When you leave the key, you get the last note. And fast repetitions, 150, 170, and 190 BPM. So, this is what you can play with. You have pizzicato and colegno, which I really love. You get the pizzicato that you have in the Special Edition Volume 1. The plus adds the snap pizzicato and the colegno. And let's get to the harmonics there. Starting with the staccatos again. With the sustains. And the harmonic marcato again with CC1 controlling the amount of the marcato. And we have the sul ponticello on the G1 key switch, staccatos, sustains, marcato again, and my favorite, the tremolo ponticello. All right, so that's the structure of all string sections. Let's just go the difference between violin one. You can hear that with the staccatos already. Loading up violin two gives you a totally different approach to the instrument. It also shows you there's a slightly different... They're on the same position. You can see that here in the mixer page when you click on this little button that shows the impulse response. You see that that's the second violins, the first violins to the left. If I load in the first violin, it's the first violin of the first violin section. So you have two different sounds there. The Violin 2 is a new addition to the Special Edition Volume, to the Synchronized Special Edition Volume 1. And the same articulations again in the plus section with short detachés. It's also cool how different the staccatos are between those two. Detaché short. Normal detaché. With a lot of vibrato, legato repetitions, spiccato repetitions. So again, a whole choice with the second violin, new choices, violin one, violin two is new. The viola, same structure, different sound. Switching to legato. And of course, you want to hear the portamento. Just beautiful instruments. First cello, again a favorite. We're going to switch to the legato right away. You also see that it changes in the positioning. All the instruments are now in the right dynamic relation and also in the right position. Here the cellos to the right. Portamento. Oh, and of course now I've hit the wrong key switch. With the instruments that are playing in a lower range, the key switches might have changed. So you can always see the key switches that you're using here are now up here on C7. And I'm switching between legato and portamento up here. It's just beautiful how you can play with those instruments already positioned, ready for you to go crazy with an orchestra setup like you probably haven't had it before. Definitely not as beautiful as in this player and with this interface. So you have one cello, but you also have a second cello. Cello 2 has been included with the Special Edition Volume 1 and Plus. Just he listened to the comparison. Again, the legato. Again, the same key switches. Beautiful tone. Key switches up here. Wait a minute here. Portamento. And let's try the high portamento. You can go on playing forever. And of course, you have the double bass. It's always the same structure. It's always the same things hiding behind here. Tremolo of the double bass, great. Love the Sul Ponticello there. I always love the Ponticello tremolo is something that I just can't get out of my head. I love it. Of course, the legato is always great. If you're looking for the key switches like I do now, they're up here. You can always see what I'm doing. You can always see those dimensions switching between articulations and the types that are, these are the folder slots, these are the articulation, the patch slots that contain the different articulations. The mixing page, if you want to have your double bass a little bit further away, just click on the mixer presets and take the distant setting. Here we go. Let me switch to legato again. So it's all, the setup is always the same, the solo strings with the new Violin 2 and Cello 2 in Volume 1. Orchestra strings. What's really cool is that you get with the Volume 1 and all the other Volume 1, 2, 4, you just get a second violin section that automatically is placed correctly, as you can see here. So you have first violins, second violins, violas, basses, and cellos down here. Sounds like this. I've played that in the Synchron Player video as well. Great to play with. Plus articulation gives you more, but even with just this Volume 1, you just get really, really far. And it's got this airy sound already. Also with the help of the EQ settings that we have applied in the mixer, you have a per channel EQ, so you can actually, we've just cleaned up the mix a little bit so that everything really fits together with the SYNCHRON ized special editions, even more out of the box than the VI special editions before. Second violins sound like this. Let's go to the legatos again, direct comparison. Little shift in the stereo image, the 10 violas, and stay with the legato. And the portamento. That's what's going to happen to you. Just keep on playing the cellos. Here we go. The big cello section. Double basses. Stick to the staccato there. Great section. And of course, for the orchestral strings, you have a multi-convolution setup where you have all the different instruments stacked. You can see that here with the with this button up here. It's the parallel button, so these slots are all set in parallel. They also have different mixer channels, so if you want to play all the strings, that's all the orchestral strings, and I'm switching to the long notes, laid out on the whole keyboard, you can do that here. The range button here lets you see where the violins have been mapped, where the violas are, and you can also see that here in the mixer, which section is playing. We're starting with the violins. Adding the violas in the mid range. And bringing in the cellos. And of course the basses in the low regions. Simple things, lots of fun. You can see here quite some work done to clean up the frequency spectrum with the EQs. All of this is included. That's the little gems that are really cool. Positioning with dedicated impulse responses at Synchron Stage Vienna. So everything's placed and positioned for you, ready to go. You also have a multi-convolution and a flat stereo set for this kind of option, where that's more CPU friendly, and you just get all the orchestra strings in a flat stereo mix. With a single convolution, but everything's panned out. If you're running into CPU troubles, this is a good option. Should be fine. Orchestra strings. Okay, this is the harp, plucked instruments. Beautiful harp with harmonics here, limited range.